Hey, my name is Felipe and welcome to my channel. In this video, I'm going to show you how to learn computer vision in 30 days. I have selected 30 computer vision projects that are going to help you to learn computer vision. These projects I have selected are going to take you from zero, from having absolutely no background in computer vision whatsoever, up to a skilled computer vision practitioner. I have selected 30 very different projects from many different industries, different use cases, different technologies. We're going to be creating web applications, APIs, Python projects, JavaScript. There is a little of everything in these 30 projects. And now let's get started with day one. Day one, OpenCV course. On the first day, you will learn how to handle images in OpenCV and perform essential operations such as blurring, thresholding, and edge detection. These foundational skills will give you a strong starting point for working with images, enabling you to approach more complex projects later on. Day 2, color detection. Sometimes we underestimate the power of simple image processing techniques. On day 2, you'll learn to create a robust object detector using simple color detection. By understanding how to isolate and identify colors in an image, you will be able to track and detect specific objects effectively, a powerful technique in applications like traffic lights or object counting. Day 3, Face Anonymizer. We will explore how to anonymize faces using a face detector and some simple image processing functions like blurring. This is an essential tool for privacy-related applications where protecting the identity of individuals is a priority. This is a beginner tutorial that will help you get started in computer vision. Day 4, Text Detection. We will benchmark popular text detection technologies like AWS TextRact, ECOCR, and Tesseract. It's important to start developing an intuition for how these tools perform in different scenarios. You'll learn their strengths and weaknesses and when to use them depending on factors like accuracy, speed, and ease of use. Day 5, Image Classification. Image classification is one of the most important tasks in computer vision. On day 5, you will create a simple but robust image classifier using scikit-learn. I walk you through the steps of training a model to recognize images, giving you an understanding of how classification works and how to build your own classifiers for custom projects. Day 6, Emotion Detection. Classifying people's emotion is an important application with uses ranging from entertainment to security. In this tutorial, we will use facial landmarks to detect emotions. By analyzing specific points on the face, we can infer emotional states such as happiness, sadness, or anger. This simplified approach gives a practical introduction to the more complex field of emotion recognition. Day 7, Feature Extraction. On day 7, I'm going to show you a very simple technique to extract features from images and discuss how these features can significantly improve the performance of machine learning models. Understanding this process is fundamental to building more accurate and efficient models. Day 8, Sign Language Detection. On day 8, you will learn how to develop a sign language detection project using computer vision techniques. We will explore various approaches to solving the problem and then build a solution based on the classification of hand landmarks. By the end of the day, you will have a functional model that can accurately translate hand gestures into sign language. Day 9, Pneumonia Classification. On day 9, you will build a web application to classify pneumonia cases using computer vision. I will guide you through the full process of developing a model that analyzes chest X-ray images to detect signs of pneumonia. You will also learn how to integrate this model into an user-friendly web application using Streamlit. Day 10, AWS Recognition. You will learn how to use AWS recognition for object detection in images and videos. This is a great starting point for working with cloud-based services and developing advanced computer vision solutions. You will see how AWS recognition can detect hundreds of objects without needing to train a custom model, making it a very convenient solution for many use cases. Day 11, Object Tracking. On day 11, I will show you a super simple way to do object detection and object tracking simultaneously. We will be using a YOLO-based model, which is an amazing technology for real-time object detection. Understanding and implementing object tracking is crucial for applications like surveillance, autonomous driving, and other advanced fields. Day 12, image segmentation. We will cover the fundamentals of image segmentation, a computer vision technique used to partition images into meaningful regions. I will walk you through the full process, from annotating images to training a custom image segmentation model. By the end, you will have a comprehensive understanding of how to segment images effectively for various applications. Day 13, post detection. Post detection is an extremely important task in computer vision with applications in interactive gaming, physical therapy, and human-computer interaction. In this tutorial, you will explore the full process of building a post detector, including data collection, annotation, and model training. Day 14, parking space counter. On day 14, you will learn how to build a robust and very modular parking spot detector and counting system using image classification, object detection, and super advanced mathematical operations. By the end, you will have a flexible system for accurately monitoring and managing parking spaces in a parking lot. Day 15, object detection with YOLO V10. I'm going to show you the entire process of training an object detector using YOLO V10, one of the most recent versions of YOLO. I will guide you through preparing your data and training the model, either in a Google Colab or locally in your own computer. Day 16, end-to-end project. I'm going to walk you through a complete end-to-end computer vision project, from initial requirements up to the project deliverable. This tutorial will provide you with a comprehensive view of how real-world projects are developed, giving you practical experience into each step of the process. Day 17, Image Processing API. We will be setting up an Image Processing API in the cloud using AWS services. I'm going to show you how to prepare and deploy the API with AWS Lambda and API Gateway, allowing you to create a scalable and serverless image processing solution. Day 18, Dataset Size Analysis. On day 18, we will try to answer the question of how much data is needed to train an object detector. I will guide you through a practical experiment, analyzing how performance changes with datasets of different sizes. By the end, you will understand how dataset size impacts on model performance. Day 19, document classification. I will walk you through a real-world document classification project from my previous freelance work. You will learn how to classify documents into different categories. This hands-on experience will provide practical insights into real-world projects beyond basic coding tutorials. Day 20, Detector and Tube. On day 20, you will learn how to implement object detection using Detectron 2, a powerful framework developed by Facebook AI Research. Understanding various computer vision technologies, including Detectron 2, is crucial for selecting the most suitable tool for different use cases. Day 21, Face Recognition with JavaScript. Face recognition technology has diverse applications, including secure authentication, personalized marketing, and automated tagging in photos. In day 21, I will show you how to implement face recognition with JavaScript using the functionality of the Face API JS library. Day 22, Face Attendance System. Moving on with face recognition, we will be working on a face attendance system with Python. I'm going to show you how to detect and identify faces in real time, how to automate attendance recording, and how to put everything together in a face attendance system which could potentially be used in workplaces, schools, and events. Day 23, intruder detection. Another application of computer vision in the cloud, we will be setting up an intruder detection system with AWS. I'm gonna show you how to use different AWS services to detect unauthorized individuals in real time, triggering alerts and actions in case of intrusion. Day 24, LangChain. On day 24, I'm going to show you how to build a web application using LangChain that allows users to chat with the images. This is an amazing MVP that could evolve into a fully functional product in fields like e-commerce, education, or customer service. Day 25, face generation. Now moving on to some of the most advanced projects, we will be training a face generation model using Stable Diffusion and Dream Boot. You will learn how to train the model on a specific identity so it generates images of that person in various styles. Day 26, spoofing detection. On day 26, we will continue working on the face attendance system, but we will incorporate a spoofing detection feature. So we will try to detect spoofing attempts and only allow users to log in or log out if they are physically present and not holding someone else's picture. Day 27, face matching. Another one involving face recognition. On day 27, you will learn how to implement face matching using DeepFace. We will be comparing two faces to determine if they belong to the same person or not. This technique is perfect for applications in identity verification, security, and authentication systems. Day 28, background removal web application. I'm going to show you how to build a web application for background removal using the Segment Anything model and a serverless API. We will be creating a fast and scalable solution that automatically removes the image backgrounds, ideal for fields like e-commerce, graphic design, and social media content creation. Day 29, license plate detection on a Raspberry Pi. On day 29, we will explore computer vision on Edge by performing real-time license plate detection on a Raspberry Pi and an USB Coral accelerator, perfect for use cases like parking management, traffic monitoring, and security enforcement. Day 30, synthetic dataset. This is a super advanced project. This tutorial guides you through creating a synthetic dataset. While data is crucial for training models, there are many situations where real data is either unavailable or insufficient. By generating synthetic data, you can overcome any limitation you may have with the data collection process and generate a diverse and high-quality dataset to train your models. So this is going to be all for these 30 days of computer vision. I hope you enjoy it. And this was a very comprehensive collection of many different type of projects, different industries, different technologies, and I hope you enjoy it a lot. Now let's play a game. Let's do something. Tell me in the comments below, what's your favorite project from all the projects I show you in the 30 days of computer vision? Tell me in the comments below. My name is Felipe, and see you on my next video.